when you look at the history of drug discovery, especially if we talk about antibiotics, we haven't found many of the new drugs since 1970. Only a few new drugs that just came out in the market in 2000. The thing about finding new drugs is that antibiotics, they are natural products. 90% of them are from bacteria and fungi. To find a totally new structure of chemical compounds that we can use as a new drug, computer, even a lot of software, you can come up with that. So, like for example, penicillin, you can see that we have modified it, but still the core structure of penicillin, the computer cannot know that. You need to go find rare or less studied bacteria, which will be the source of the drug production. So that's why a lot of us that are in this field, we like to go into extreme habitats, whether it be deep down, you know, in the ocean sediments or desert or hot spring, or go into different type of caves to find really superheroes, I would say, the types of bacteria or fungi or microorganisms that live in such extreme habitats that they could potentially have a different and new metabolic pathway that we haven't seen before, in the hope that we could find new drugs from that. So now you have two camps of bacteria, the bad bacteria, and then we have another camp of the type of bacteria that produce metabolites for us as antibiotics. The metabolites can kill the cell wall of the bad bacteria, or it can inhibit DNA replication or RNA function of the bad bacteria. Now, all of these bad bacteria have gained so much ability to resist our existing antibiotics, so we need to find new antibiotics. So basically, my student and I go to the cave, we collect soil sample or rock sample, and then we take it out back to the lab, and then we isolate as many as we can in the lab, and then we ferment them and see what thing they produce, and then we extract it to see whether those compounds kill bad bacteria. And you know what? Thousands of metabolites have been discovered, but when you get to the FDA approval, the, you know, like clinical trial, many levels of it, and produce it in the industrial setting, from my experience, it takes 10 to 25 years to be able to develop one new antibiotic. Depend on on your standard of danger, I guess. Yeah, I found that caves are mysterious, don't you think? It's like, who actually could live in caves? Where do microorganisms that live in the caves get their nutrients from, their food from? In the caves, there are lots of mineral deposits, and certain groups of bacteria can actually extract energy from those minerals. When you think about it, we live with bacteria. Bacteria and microorganisms are everywhere. We cannot live without them. But don't you think that they often get bad press? How many people know that less than 1% of microorganisms make us sick? That microorganisms make up to about 3 pounds of us in an average healthy adult. So we can't really think about us as an individual anymore. I'm trying to tell my students, we should think of us as we are a system as well. As a human species, we try to live in this clean bubble. We need to be less afraid of bacteria. That's why I go to caves, because we do live with them. We cannot live without them.
In 20 years, the consciousness of humanity went from, gosh, I wish there's got to be like some planets out there, to now, so there are literally billions, maybe trillions, of planets in our galaxy.